Everybody, welcome to the Crit House. You have just seen the work of Eddy Pula and the photography that we're going to be discussing here on the program today. And I am so excited about the grouping of people we have here. Ellen Friedlander, who is such a friend of the program, is here with us. She is an LA-based photo artist and the co-director of the Pasadena Photography Arts. She has been exhibited internationally with her photography. She's been featured on things like Lens, Scratch, The Hand Magazine, and my favorite podcast out there, the Candid Frame with Iberian X Perillo, is just amazing. And somewhere in this crazy mess of a studio is her book, which is and I'm forgetting the name. What's the name of your book?
The Extended Frame.
The Extended Frame. Thank you very much. So, which is an amazing book. It is here somewhere in this room, and I was going to show it, but I just moved into this house and I can't find it in all the boxes that I have here. I am so excited, though, to have with us here Jamie Windsor in the lower left. Jamie, thank you for coming on the Crit House. It's great to have you. Jamie is a photographer.
Thank you for having me.
It's just an honor to have you here with us. You're primarily focused on portraits and weddings and interiors, but I came to know you from your YouTube channel, where you feature a mix of tips and reviews and techniques. But for me, what always was very impressive about your YouTube channel is your discussion about the philosophical and the ethical questions of photography and the practice. And so your YouTube channel was, for me, it always has been, a learning experience. So it's a real honor to have you here on the Crit House. So thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Eddy Pula is here with us. He is here in New England. He went to the Massachusetts College of Art and Design, where when he was there, he started photographing strangers on the streets. And he has kept at it since he left college, traveling across the country and making portraits of people who catch his eye. So Eddy, why don't you tell us a little bit about the photography and maybe what it is that you're looking to learn from the discussion that we have here with Jamie and Ellen?
I'm obsessed with portraits, with like finding people on the street. I've been doing this style. It's obviously deeply indebted to Deanne Arbus. And I guess I'm looking for help on is, I feel like I've kind of photographed myself into a rut. I've been doing this style for years now. I think I still want to, you know, photograph people, but maybe getting more variety or maybe some kind of narrative.
Jamie Windsor, let's have you start off. What do you see in the work? What are your thoughts about the work?
It's interesting, actually. You said Deanne Arbus, because I went through your images earlier. I made a few notes. I've just written that at the top because I saw like an element of that in there. I've also written Joel Sternfeld. I think some of the color ones. You've got a really fantastic way of working with your subjects. You've really got. You seem to be able to get like that, them to interact with the camera or with you in a really nice way. There's some particular standout shots, I think, for me, the girl with two people who I assume are her parents maybe. And, you kind of cut the heads off, but I really like that. And she sort of just stands out. And there's just something really nice about this image. I like the way, I don't know how I'm going to say, like her mum, I don't know, is like gripping her arm. And there's just a lot of questions. I think portraits that really grab me are ones that have a lot of sort of questions in, you know. She's got this sort of big hat on and she's holding this dog, and it just, and I like the way you can't see the heads of the adults. There's something about that that I really like. So I think there's another one I really like. It's number 10, I thought
is beautiful.
It's absolutely fantastic, isn't it? It's just the pose, just the way, just the kind of, you know, like her dress with the background just kind of has this sort of it's sort of almost like mirroring that kind of pattern there. That's a really fantastic shot. There's quite a few going through that I just think are really stunning shots.
Well, Ellen, let's bring you in before we go on to like specific images. Ellen, what are your thoughts about the work and then your suggestions?
Well, I agree with Jamie. I mean, this photograph, I was going to call it up myself. It's just magical. But I want to address what you're really here for, because your portraits are amazing. I too went through your website and looked you up and saw your work online, and you've been doing this for a long time, which is amazing and shows. But we're in a world with photography is everywhere. So it's now, what do you do with this? And I think that there's a couple different ways to attack that. It could be a book, you know, but not just a regular book. You got to like, you know, I kind of almost feel like you could play with it. You could cut the people out. You could have the photograph and cut the people out, have the people on another page. You could push the medium from being just a straight portrait to making the audience get a little bit more involved with your process and taking the people out of their environment, just kind of playing. In addition to that, I would suggest, you know, stories. People are really big into stories. Who are these people? I'm all about, like, how do we push photography in a world where everybody has a camera today? It's hard.
I think everyone's making self-portraits all the time. I think it's a little more critical. I think one thing that really disturbs me about cell phone self-portraits is a lot of them automatically clean up your skin without even you asking. I've always been kind of weirded up by that. I try to have these straight and, you know, I don't like Photoshop out people's pimples or wrinkles or anything. So it's not how the way people would represent themselves or their friends, I don't think.
And this is such a wonderful portrait of this gentleman staring right at us. But again, so it's kind of a juxtaposition of how do you want people to see your work where people are inundated by portraiture? How do you make this stand out? So that's the biggest question here. How do you make people want to stop in a world? So like this portrait of these two young women with their, is it caricatures or, you know, what, how do we put them on a page? I mean, I think honestly, it's about playing with portraiture now, pushing it even in an exhibition, you could play with making these straight portraits just a little bit. Maybe you said you want to change it up a little bit. Maybe it's a little edgier. Maybe it's a different angle. You're straight on most of the time. You're not shooting up. You're not shooting down. You're not shooting, you know, at oblique angles. You're not kind of getting really close to their face. You're not distorting them. I mean, there's all these different ways that you can kind of go in there and go, okay, I've done this type of portraiture. Now, what do I do to like put me in there?
So one of the things that I think about when I'm seeing this, and this is beyond my skill and understanding level, is like, what's the story here? Eddie, maybe you know that, but I guess that's the question that I have for you is you've got some lovely images, but like, what's the story? You know, Deanne Arbus, there's a story behind her work. You know, maybe it was told after the fact, but I mean, there's a story about her work, and I'm not sure what it is that you're saying or what it is you're trying to communicate. Have you thought about that? What is it like when you describe this project? How do you describe it? What's your thumbnail?
I don't have a great explanation. I actually am working on a book. I think, you know, in sequence, maybe they kind of tell a little bit, not really a story, but juxtaposing the different people, kind of showing you, I think about it a little bit anthropologically, Think about a little bit like August Sonder, people of the 20th century. I kind of want to show the great chaotic masses. One thing I do think about both Sonder and more Diane Arbus is their captions add a lot of meaning, and I don't have captions. I don't know much about these people. I photograph them in like less than a minute and I walk off and I never see them again. I wonder if that is like a big deficit to the work.
Jamie?
Well,
or I'm sorry, Ellen, if you wish.
There feels like there's a social commentary going on as a body of work. I'm not entirely sure what that is. And I think that one thing that sticks out with all these photos is that they're all, that there's quite a lot of difference between kind of the approach of them. Like some are very much portraits of people like that, and they're very much engaging with the camera, with the audience. And then there's some which seem a little more kind of almost documentarian, a bit kind of candid, like they seem sort of two very different kind of things to me. So I'm kind of wondering if it's not connected via a style, or then is it connected via a story? So is it connected via some sort of, because I mean, like for example, this image is dramatically different to I think even just the one before it, even though they're similar in some ways. So I'm kind of like, I feel like I don't kind of know what it is. Is it just that kind of street portraiture? And I think when you have that, there are some very strong images here where I think, as I said before, there are a lot of like questions, and there's a lot in them to see. And I think that they hold together. So like a photo like this, for example, I don't kind of know how this one fits in with maybe like the guy with the pigeons, or is it?
For me, so, it's about the next, like this and then the next one. Like this person's more androgynous, softer, it's like hyper-masculine.
I mean, it feels very reportage, that shot. And it's a really nice shot kind of on its own, but he's not, like this doesn't feel like a portrait. It feels like it's a moment. I think it might just be because he's not posing as such. He's not kind of because the other people are sort of engaging with the camera and stuff. So I'm kind of wondering, is it just are these all from a particular area?
I mean, a lot of them are in Boston, but I've been traveling the last couple of years.
Right.
Hitting up different cities to photograph them.
This one again feels very it's a really nice, I really like this one as a shot, but it feels very, very different to a lot of the others. But maybe not in terms of a, like the underlying narrative. Maybe there's a social commentary going on there. Maybe it's showing all different kinds of people in an area or something. I think I feel like it, and I think I have to be quite kind of, if I'm just looking for something to sort of criticize with, because I think there's some really, really stunning images here. I think as a body, there needs to be a bit more kind of, a sort of, sort of harsher editing maybe, or this guy here, I love this shot. It's nice, like you've got that kind of environmental, you can see enough of the background to link the character, you know, so it becomes, the portrait becomes slightly environmental, but it's not kind of one of those sort of far back sort of environmental shots. But then the one before feels very much like they're in sort of mid movement, there's a lot of shots of people smoking and this guy with the smoker's rights. Is that all one thing?
I call that the smoking section.
Right. Okay. Is that all from different times or?
Oh yeah. Some of these are like 10 years old. Some of these are a year old. Okay.
Cause then you've got the guy after smoking a cigar again, that feels the real close up feels a bit like one of those sort of close up sort of Bruce Gilden type shots, which again feels very different to the rest of the work, but again is a really interesting shot in its own right. So I think, I mean, even just that sort of section, like you said, of the smoking section, that is something that sort of holds them together. But I think as a wider body, I'm wondering what it is that kind of, I love that shot too. So I love this one. I don't know, something about just the tones in it just kind of work. It's just very nicely composed.
You had a thought a minute ago that I think I cut you off on.
But that's okay. I'm kind of playing with the photographs that you have here. So it's almost like if you have number 10, the lovely photograph of the young girl, and then on the opposite page, you did have like something outrageous, like 21, you know, what it, you know, it's so dramatic. You know, so if you were to play with that and the photographs really aggressively, you know, counterintuitively placed together, that's a social commentary. So it's all about how you put the photographs together in conversation that's going to create another story, right? That I can see as being another way of putting the photographs together that would be jarring to the viewer and make them think a little bit differently about what you're doing. So that's where you also have control. The number 18. Yeah. And then you could have number 14 on the opposite page, which is the kind of the androgynous. I mean, that's like, I'm very curious, like I'm confused. I don't know what's going on here. So you're making the viewer kind of ask questions. That's another way you can go. You could try, I mean, it's all about engagement, I think now, about people being forced to stop and be forced to be curious. So by pairing photographs really unusually, you could perhaps get people to stop. You know, it's all about engagement.
Eddie, question for you. So before we started off, you said that there was a particular, you had them ordered in a specific order, and that was important. Can you talk about that? Because if the ordering was important, tell us about why that is.
I've been working on a book, and I've been thinking a lot about the dip, you know, one picture here, one picture there, the way they work is diptychs and the way they work. I mean, like, yeah, those are both, you know, they have the cross, people are showing me something. It's a child and that and strange adults. This is kind of like a shortened version of the book. The book is about 50 pages, and this is like 30 of them.
Uh-huh.
I'm trying to, yeah, create contrast from one person to the next.
So similar to what Ellen was saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, that makes me think, what about your social commentary? What about you taking your, you've been doing this for years, okay? You can now kind of string your poetry of being on the street. So you give the viewer, you give real weight to your work by actually placing your thoughts after photographing, making portraits for years, And you just have, maybe it's just a word on each page. Maybe it's a chain of words. Maybe it's two photographs and then a little something that on a single page, you have five, just something to give people a little different viewpoint that you can bring to the party after all these years of photographing portraits on the street.
I keep coming back to this image. I think this is lovely. I don't know why I like this, but
oh, it's beautiful.
I'm drawn to it.
There's a lot in that shot. I think there's that. I think that shot in itself has that juxtaposition in with the kind of urban scene and the way he's kind of the guy's kind of holding himself and the clothes he's wearing sort of juxtaposed with the little kid with the kind of just sort of that he's getting quite a, his body language is almost a little bit sort of shy and he's kind of got a very sort of innocent look on his face. And I think also the way the background just goes off into darkness and these people are kind of lit and they just sort of stood out. But he's got that shadow across his eyes. It's just, there's so much in this that makes a really arresting image for me.
Yeah. It'd
be an interesting cover.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. All right. So as we start to wrap up, let me just go to you, Ellen, and let you give your last thoughts on maybe a direction or something we haven't talked about that Eddie might want to think about.
Well, your work is wonderful. So, you know, huge kudos because it's really dynamic. The portraiture is arresting. Do you see Deanne Arbus in there? Do you see Ouija in there? Do you see, you know, Robert Frank's in there? You nailed your portraiture. Now it's all about you putting your stamp. So that's what I would say. It's all about your stamp on this portraiture that makes it removed from history and put your historic stamp on it. So that's kind of the chore that we have to do as photographers is how do we, and this is an absolutely gorgeous image, by the way.
It is.
You know, back cover. Just, it's all about intriguing. You know, it's all about like making people curious. So, you know, push people to say, I want to open that book kind of thing.
So I hear Ellen volunteering as being one of your book designers. Jamie Windsor, what are your thoughts for Eddie as we wrap things up? What takeaways that he should remember?
Well, I think Ellen really hit it on the head when she talked about like the juxtaposition of it's all about how you put them together. Now I think that's the real key here. I mean there's so many fantastic images, and I think what, as I said earlier, what's kind of lacking for me is like sort of why they kind of exist, you know, why one exists and then the other one. But I think if they're put together in the right way, you can start to build a meaning and a story and a commentary into it. And I'm thinking slightly as well, and not in terms of style, but in terms of the kind of the way narrative kind of comes through of like people like Nan Goldin too, who kind of just take these sort of shots that are a mixture of portraits and sort of just things going on and just people. But there's quite a wealth of different kind of events going on, but they feel like they hold together as a collection. And I think something interesting about her work is when she does those slideshows, and it's all about kind of the order and that I think when Ellen said about that just clicked into place for me. Like it's all about how they're kind of put together. And I think just working out what it is that you want to say with your images. I mean, there's such powerful ones in there. The girl with the Trump thing, and I think the final one as well with the girl with is it a boy or I don't know. And they're wearing like a SWAT team thing. They've got a baton. It's a child. I think it's number 31. And this I just find really, it's just like why are they wearing that when it's sort of looks like it's in the park or something. It seems very. and I think the face mask as well, and just it, there's all these things I think get put just next to the right image, and it's gonna give it that context, and it's gonna make it just it's just gonna emphasize that sort of power.
So it all strikes me as sort of the great challenge of photographers of trying to figure out what the story is. You know, what's the project statement that you suffer over trying to figure out what it is you're doing. And these hopefully, Eddy, this will be a good input for you to try to figure that out and go in that direction, because there are some great images. It really is an enjoyable body of work to take a look at. So thank you for showing it here on the Crit House. It's always, I know it's hard for photographers to come on to show their work and get input. So I appreciate that. For anyone out there who's watching, if you do want to show your work on the Crit House, you can do that at our website by going to thecrithouse.com. There's a tab for show your work or to participate in the Crit House. Eddy, thank you. Thank you. Ellen Friedlander, it's a great always to have you on the program. And we are, again, so honored, Jamie Windsor, to have you participate here on the Crit House. You have been such an inspiration to me, and I know thousands of other photographers who look at your YouTube channel. We're going to have a link to a couple of Jamie's videos here, which I promise you will be impressed with and you will learn from. And I want to thank you all for joining us here on the Crit House.